We are going to release the report called Challenges for Retail Real Estate in India's Transitioning Society. You won't be surprised because most of the points we've covered in our panel discussion, but anyways, I don't have a presentation here to show to everyone, but I'll quickly summarize through pointers what we have tried to convey in this report. Retail as a sector has gone through significant amount of transitions across the globe as well as in India. From the basic expectation of a good customer service, consumers of today anticipate much more. They anticipate a retail theater from the retailers as well as mall developers to demonstrate a retail theater. Retail malls are becoming destinations of not just merely shopping but leisure and entertainment and quality family time. Look at malls in the West, where retail is slightly more advanced probably than India. You see a mall in Turkey which is located close to a beach, right across the beach, and you have an underwater aquarium there. What are they trying to do? You see a mall in Madrid where it has the largest indoor ice skating podium. What are they trying to do? Basically, these malls are trying to attract, or probably bring out an element of thrill, an element of, experiential retailing, which we've already heard so many times, from the potential shoppers. So when shoppers come for, it's not just merely for coming to a mall for shopping, it's probably to get an experience and an element of thrill from these malls. In India, we are probably some distance away from witnessing that kind of a retail theater. Maybe we are not yet, developed on that front. However, we are seeing a transition of our own here. Look at what e-commerce has done to, retail sector as a whole in the last 2 years. It has completely transformed the way we all shop. What have they done? Merely innovate and take support of two things which has improved in India over the last couple of years. One is a spectacular rise in internet penetration. Secondly, a spectacular rise in penetration of smartphones. And on the back of that, it's not just merely the infrastructure that they are banking on. What they have done is really innovate. Has the retail real estate sector done this over the last 2 years? All we have been doing, or all the real estate sector has been doing, is defending. Probably now it's time for the real estate sector to innovate. So when e-commerce as a sector is growing, at a fantastic pace, questions are being raised whether malls would become unviable going forward. Experience from, observation, what we've just noted in the West, and even Subhranshu was telling about the US market, where e-commerce is rendered only 20-25%, despite being in existence for several years. We believe that that will happen in India as well. Physical as well as online retail will coexist. But what are the things that need to happen? Two things. One, for the developers, they need to ensure faster adaptation to this retail theater syndrome as and when it catches up in India. Number two, for retailers, they need to be sure which category are they selling and whether that category fits into what channel, whether it's online, whether it's offline, whether it's a combination of both, and if it's a combination of both, then what proportions. In the last 2 years, we have seen categories, this already happening, categories such as books, electronics, swiftly moving to the online platform. However, there are categories like apparels and fashions which probably still strongly prefer the offline mode or physical format mode. Not to forget that luxury is one category which is soon emerging in India. And from the global experience, that is one category which strongly prefers the physical format of retailing. Within India, we have different cities which are in different level of transitions. Take, for instance, the tier one city, Bangalore, Delhi, Mumbai. It has already started to embrace luxury retailing in various stages. On the other hand, we have cities such as Kolkata,